Oh, hi, Malcolm Nance. Hi. Hi.
Oh, hi.
How are you doing? I'm the calm one. I don't know why.
Well, all I know is I was up a good piece of the night and got a couple of hours sleep.
Yeah.
Then went on air this morning.
Yeah.
And then got a couple of more hours sleep. Well, let's just put it this way. The counting of the ballots and the drawing out of this election, which is trending well, has managed to sort of defuse a lot of the violent rhetoric that we were seeing amongst right-wing extremists.
Yeah.
They, as I said, they live in an alternate world, Steph. They think they've won.
Yes.
They've been told that
they've won. Well, because Donald Trump said that last night.
Yeah.
As we knew.
So right now, they believe that all those ballots are changing until, of course, Travis just told you that Donald Trump just made a pronouncement about those.
Yeah.
What did he say? What did it say again?
He said we were leading strongly in some states, and then votes were magically disappearing in Democratic-led states.
That's very true. They were disappearing into the Joe Biden column.
Yes.
Right.
It's called counting.
Yes, it's called counting the ballots. Yes.
His lead is magically disappearing. Right now, I mean, I was live when Steve Kornacki came up with like a million votes Wisconsin, and it flipped the state almost immediately.
Yeah.
Pennsylvania, they're saying that's going to happen here very, very soon. A million votes just out of Philadelphia County are going to happen. So nobody panic. All right. Civil War's not coming.
When you're the one telling us not to panic, right? Then we're it's almost Freaky Friday.
You know?
But and it's true. Listen, Malcolm, you're an old Navy intelligence guy. They told us their battle plan. We've known this for how long? They're going to try to screw with the post office. They're going to try to slow mail ballots arriving. They're going to, you know, so Donald Trump, so there's going to be a red mirage. Donald Trump's going to claim victory. Russian bots are going to chime in about, you know, fraud and whatever. And they're going to send lawyers in. And here we are, right?
Jonathan Swan said a month ago, he was the one that got this, where he had heard from Trump and all the insiders. Get a lead, declare all ballots illegal.
Yeah.
And sure enough, Trump came right out. He told us this is what he was going to do. People had been writing and talking about the red mirage, and we are into the second day. So now the red mirage is fading.
Yeah.
Somebody put it very succinctly. They said, stop thinking of 2016. Start thinking of 2018.
Thank
you. Were all panicked at the beginning, and then we weren't panicked at the end result. Now, the only thing that's very disappointing is these inroads in southern Florida to the Cuban vote, to the Hispanic vote. And all this talk about how the Democrats didn't do it. And there were turnout levels for Hillary Clinton in southern Texas. She had won by 27 points. In this one, Trump was leading by like 4, which means we evaporated all of that.
Yeah.
So there's going to need to be a checkout of what all of the Democratic Party's activities. But if we win the presidency, I think we can manage even without the Senate. And that's not a foregone conclusion either.
No, it is not. By the way, to your point, Ann in Santa Fe tweeted, as the Facebook meme says, conservatives think socialism is anything to the left of hunting the homeless for sport. But at the same time, I got to say, say the thing you just said. This is, and you knew this. Joy Reid said it last night. She said, Miami-Dade is really low.
Yeah.
That's where we saw footage of the ballot sitting in the post office.
And
apparently
in South Florida, the United States Postal Service failed to deliver around 27% of the mailed-in ballots.
I said, can you can you uncall a state?
Governor of Florida is going to make sure that one sticks.
Yeah. Yeah, and that was reported by CBS News. So.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's, you know, again, laser targeted, Malcolm, in the swing states, in the swing districts, in Democratic strongholds. You can see the postal stuff, the fail rates. They were laser targeted to Democratic areas.
At this point, let's just win the presidency.
Yep.
And next year, all that can be checked out in congressional inquiries and through a new attorney general.
Yeah.
Focus.
I thought
this is all about
I thought that it doesn't
sure
matter.
Donald Trump walks home.
Right. That's what I thought. It doesn't matter how we win. I don't care. You know what I mean? Landslide or not, which, you know, if we still win, we win. And, you know, it, like you say, go from there.
But it does prove one thing. It proves one thing, though. 50% of this country is just straight up racist.
Yeah.
They admire and adore Donald Trump's platforms. They don't care about 250,000 Americans dead. I'm really surprised. You know, Trump may in fact just be a symptom of a disease Trumpism. Like I'm going to present in this my forthcoming book on right-wing extremism, these people, his base is what's driving their attacks on us.
Yeah.
Joe Biden couldn't make a lot of inroads into him. He didn't make a lot. He's just barely above where Hillary Clinton was in Michigan and Wisconsin. They believe, and they say coronavirus isn't even one of their top four priorities. It's the economy.
Right.
You know, not the deaths of U.S. citizens. There's a huge empathy gap. And I'm afraid to say that these people have become Donald Trump.
Well, I mean, you look at we knew this wasn't going to go away overnight, Malcolm. I mean, one of the who was it? Which douchebag that got into Congress? His first tweet as a congressman is cry more, libs. Is he the Hitler enthusiast?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Yes,
he's
and
the
he
Hitler
lied
enthusiast. And then the QAnon woman.
He lied and said he was accepted to the Naval Academy. So he's a stolen valor.
Yeah.
Guy too from North Carolina, Colthurn or something.
But, yeah, and a QAnon lady got in.
And
I mean,
a crazy QAnon lady.
That kind of attitude is all over conservative media. Conservative talk shows espouse that all day long. It's been like that for 20 years to own the libs.
Yeah.
Own the libs.
All
no
they care about.
These people literally voted to have their own health care taken away.
Yeah.
They literally voted to allow people to die. They literally voted for them to implement herd immunity, which will allow 3% of 200,000,000 Americans will generally die from that. I mean, I don't understand these people. It's not that Joe Biden's a bad candidate or not empathetic or Bernie Sanders would have done worse, apparently, because these people don't care.
Yeah, if we ran an actual socialist, right?
Yeah.
I mean, calling Joe Biden a socialist.
Hey, let me tell you, I monitor their web forums. All they talk about is communist.
Yep.
We're the communists? Your guy literally exchanges love letters with communists, hangs out and kisses the butt of ex-KGB officers. And they use that word with all sincerity.
Yeah.
I mean, these are like the Proud Boy guys who have "We the People" tattooed on their arms. And they don't mean "We the People." They mean us, this Trump tribe.
Yeah.
And
Malcolm, I said it, you know, earlier that I, you know, of course I prayed to my daddy. I'm a little daddy's girl for a 1964 landslide. But I said that was not ever going to be possible. There was no Fox News, no right wing radio then. We are tribal. Malcolm, you're right. We are split into tribes, and it's there's no way you're going to have that. It is amazing. You're right. I thought the same thing last night. He's killed 250,000 of us. How many millions and millions are out of work? And some people are just like, that's good. That's okay.
They don't mind as long as it makes the libs cry.
Yeah,
that's right. And if you want to see where they're getting their ideas, watch the TV show Vikings, which is why these guys are now wearing Viking beards and cutting their hair in the bowl cut and all that stuff. They think that they are the white dominant tribe that will rule, 40% of them will rule over 60% of the country. Laws be danged, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They are going to try to dominate us.
Yeah.
My only question is, when this is all said and done, okay, will they, when they realize that it's gone, it's not in Donald Trump's hands, he is no longer going to be president, where they are going to go. And I suspect Donald Trump himself will take up the horn and will blow it and call for, and you know, the Trump insurgency that is due to come.
Right.
This is where, by the weekend, it's going to get more dangerous.
Yeah. Oh,
and
wait,
I'll
listen,
let you know, because I'll probably be there on Friday.
Yeah. What?
Where? Here?
Here?
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh?
Whoa.
No,
I'm corona negative, and I'm going to wear two masks down there.
Ah. Wow.
Oh, it makes me really nervous to have you flying, but okay. So take a listen. So take a listen to what you do. And more gaslighting, of course.
You just take a look at all of these states that we've won tonight. And then you take a look at the kind of margins that we've won them by. And all of a sudden, it's not like we're up 12 votes and we have 60% left. We won states, and all of a sudden, I said, what happened to the election? It's off. And we have all these announcers saying, what happened? And then they said, oh, because you know what happened? They knew they couldn't win. So they said, let's go to court. And did I predict this, Newt? Did I say this? I've been saying this from the day I heard they were going to send out tens of millions of ballots. I said exactly, because either they were going to win, or if they didn't win, they'll take us to court.
Oh, my God. Projection much? That's exactly right. Exactly the opposite, as usual. He knew he couldn't win. He said in advance, I'm going to send lawyers in, right?
Yeah, and did his teeth come out? He slurred his words left and right.
Oh, the slurring started yesterday or the day before. Yeah, yeah.
Well, you know, whatever they've got him hyped up on.
As you said, he's going full bunker, baby. As you said on Twitter, they're making a non-scalable fence. Baby's full on in the bunker, right?
We haven't seen it. He in his mind, he's won this election, and he's about to try to get forward with it. And then the thing that's going to smack him in the face is when he loses this election.
Yeah.
That's when he will become dangerous.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And by the way, I'll announce with you guys first, and you can all see me on Bill Maher this Friday.
Yeah. Oh, that's why you're coming. Okay. All right, but be careful.
I will be on Bill's first show in Los Angeles with an audience of 25.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
All of whom are staff.
Yeah. 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 Exactly. Well, Malcolm, I see, and this makes me nervous. I've had a couple of friends fly, and I'm, as you know, desperate to see my mother. I talked to her yesterday, Malcolm. She just went into assisted living, and because of coronavirus, she's in quarantine. She has dementia, right. So, you know, yesterday she's really disoriented, doesn't know what's happening to her. This is all because of COVID, that I can't go see her, that she's locked in a room for 2 weeks, doesn't understand where she is or why. I mean, it is heartbreaking, and there are millions of us going through it. And my fear last night, mostly when I thought, oh, my God, Trump's going to win, I will never see my mother. Well, this will go on. We are full on going to be into herd immunity, and Fauci's going to be fired this week if he wins. And so, I mean, it is a terrifying reality for a lot of us, right?
It is, because he is intent on making this nation sick, and he doesn't care. He does not care about people. And this is why I'm upset with all the people that voted for him. It's like 44%, 47%. These people don't care anymore. I'm certain it was Jason Johnson who said this on MSNBC this morning. He goes, white people, it's all on you.
Yeah.
He said, you voted for this, for death, for lack of health care, for a fake who is just out there, who has conned you into believing the economy's great for you.
Yeah.
No, tribalism. And he is the leader of that tribe, and they don't care about the other 60% of America.
Yeah.
Hang on, it's gonna get rough.
Yeah, yeah. Oh well. See, I knew we'd come full circle to you scaring the out of us. Okay. All right, Malcolm. Thank you for that. We're still gonna win.
Yep.
All right. Love you. See ya.